Hopefully this word will help you, uplift you, give you hope, as I pray it does for me. But note to myself, everybody is not going to receive you, what God has placed in you, who you are, and what you stand for when it comes to Christ. So on today, I want you to remember to pray for those that mistreat you, despitefully use you. The Bible says to pray for those that despitefully use you. So on today, just know that you pray for those that have used you in any capacity, whether it be intentionally or unintentionally, because I do believe that there are those that can use you and it in a way, and it is unintentional. My feelings have been hurt over and over again. And I want you to know that you keep pushing. If you're doing a service, don't allow your flesh to stand in the way of what God has called you to do. When my feelings got hurt, I felt like you're not recognized for the things that you do. So stop doing them. But just as quick as my flesh wanted to take over, I love how God comes in. He will step in and he will correct you. As long as you are his child and you have a heart that is open to him and you receive the things that he has for you and what he says to you, he says so quickly, daughter, keep doing your service. They don't recognize you for your service. They're using you for your service. But for me and my glory, keep doing your service. Nobody has to see you. My blog is called Hidden in God. It's what I stand for, to be hidden in God. So even if that means being in the capacity where you're not recognized, or you know, you're always in the background, he said, the first shall be last and the last shall be first. So just remember on today, pray. Pray when you feel used. Pray when you feel like your flesh is taken over. Pray when you feel like you're not walking in the spirit. Pray so that you can get back to where God wants you to be, so that you truly never even get out of that place. Yes, we're going to have those thoughts. We're going to have thoughts where your flesh wants to take over. But because you are in his word, because you stay in his word, because you consistently pray, his spirit is in control. Your spirit that is infused with his spirit is what's in control. Spirit rules the flesh. So good. To me, continue to crucify your flesh. Do not allow the enemy to come in with those thoughts of giving up or quitting. And he has been coming hard lately. I know that they don't know your struggle. I know that they don't know what you've been through. I know that they don't understand who you are. But you know who you are. You just wrote a post today that said, doesn't matter if anybody sees what God has told you to do. You know who you are. Walk in who you are. Walk in the anointing that he has given you. Do what he has called you to do. If nobody has your back but him, the Father has your back. If he be for you, who can be against you? That one, the one who is more powerful than anything in heaven and earth. If he is on your side, keep pushing, keep moving, keep serving, keep doing what you're doing. Even if you don't see the manifestation, keep the faith, Keep believing in what God has called you to do. Keep believing that those dreams and those desires and those goals that you have, He will see them to their completion. Your purpose will be fulfilled. Just keep walking. Keep walking, keep walking, keep walking. I cannot say it enough. Keep walking in the things of God. Remember who you are. At every turn, as the enemy comes with every fiery dart that he will throw, the Bible says that these things are coming. Don't be surprised when the trials, the fiery trials come. Keep walking. Keep serving. I can't say it enough. Keep serving. Because your service is for the glory of God. Your service is for God to get the glory out of your life. Your service is for Him to be exalted. It's not about you. It's not about you. It's about Him. And it's about others who are watching you walk. Who are watching your lifestyle. Keep walking. Don't give up. Keep serving. In Jesus' name. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for watching. Look forward to the next note. In Jesus' name. Bye.